Good morning, children. Yesterday, I have explained you the lesson, okay, which I started in the first video, that was about the polar regions. Okay, I explained you about what are polar regions. Okay, now even I showed one picture which explained the divisions of the climatic zones. Okay, I explained you where the climatic zones are seen, the temperate zone and the equatorial belt, what we call it as tropical zone. Or fissured zone. So here you can see that this pink area shows the fissured zone. And then location, I told you that this area is nothing but the location of the fissured zone. Okay, that is polar regions. Okay, so they say that the surrounding the two poles are called as what? Polar regions. Okay, so then I explained you about the north fissured zone and south fissured zone. Then you can see that what type of climate is found here, that I have explained you. Okay, so here you can see that days, longer days will be in summer and longer nights will be in winters. Okay, so when the standing rays will be there on the northern pole. So same way, that same time what will happen, the southern hemisphere will experience winter season, where they will have longer nights. Okay, so all these things I explained you. And then when I started the land, okay, so here you can see that polar regions, land remains covered with the snow and ice. I told you that most of the polar regions will be covered with the snow and ice. Okay, so what happens now? The low lands which are there in the Arctic Circle nearby, so there the snow starts melting. Okay, when the snow starts melting, you can see that there it turns into, it forms small streams and then pools. You can see that. And the high lands which are there near the North Pole and South Pole, it will be in a frozen form. Okay? So this I explained you. Even I told you about the cold desert, which is the largest cold desert here in the world, the Antarctica. Okay? So as we know that the South Pole is totally covered with the continent, that is Antarctica. Even I gave you the Arctic. Okay? So hope you all might have done this Arctic, okay, which I have given you yesterday, that you have to find out and write five animals which live in the polar regions. Okay. So today I am going to start this the second part of this lesson, that is the plants and animals. So what type of plants are seen here? What type of animals are found here? That we are going to study. Okay. So as you can see that it is a freezing area. Okay. It's in the frozen air point, and you can see that most of the weather will be cold. The climate will be totally freezing cold. Okay. So, but still there you can see that some plants and animals are found. Okay. So, when snow melts in summer, a thin layer appears. So, what happens now when the snow starts melting in summer? A thin layer appears. Okay. So, what happens in that area? You can see that short shrubs, then grasses, and you can see that mostly starts growing. Okay. So it will be having small shrubs and it starts growing on that thin layer. Okay, so but the lower level of the soil remains frozen. So wherever you find that the thin layer, below that it will be in the frozen form. Okay, so there will be there you can't find any trees or deep rooted plants. Okay, they cannot grow below that thin layer. Okay, so this is clear to you all. Then you can see that this is the vegetation in polar region. You can see that is Antarctic algae. Okay, so one type of algae which grows in the Antarctic region. Okay, and then they say that Antarctic hair grass. It looks like hair, and it is grown in the, it grows in the Antarctic region. Okay, then you can see that even the Antarctic pearl wall, what we call it as, it also grows in that Antarctic region. Okay, so it will grow the stones also. Anywhere it will get the base. Okay? And also you can see that this is the mostly seen in the polar regions, that is lichens, we can call it as. Okay, so this will be grown on the ground level and it will be stick with the surface. Now you can see that even most of the animals which have thick layer, okay, which has their skin very thick, and you can see that even which will be having thick fat under the skin, you can see that thick layer of skin. So they, you can see that they can keep them protected from this freezing cold. Okay, and also the animals which will be having thick fur, okay, animals will be having thick fur? Can you tell me? Okay. Now, polar bear. Okay, so even you can see that these animals will be having thick fur. Okay, so these animals can protect themselves from the freezing cold. Okay, then this in some seasons you can see them, and you can see that to the warm places. So what happened now? Seasonally they migrate. Okay, sorry, they migrate from that place to the another place as it will be too cold in the winter season. So what they do? They go to the warmer places, and you can see that. Even this is one reason, because of the harsh cold, they will move to the warmer places, and also there will be a shortage of food, which will force them to move to the areas where they can get food for their livelihood. Okay, so here you can see that during the seasons they will move to the other areas where it will be having warm climate. Okay, then in Arctic region, you can see that plants that grow in summer are eaten by some animals. Okay, so in summer season in Arctic region, their plants will be grown. Can these plants be eaten by which animals? For example, reindeer, then musk ox, and Arctic hare. Okay, so these animals eat these plants which are grown in the Arctic region. Okay, then some of the animals which are called as predators. We have already studied this word in the red grasses, where I told you the meaning of the predator. Predator means what? The animals which eat animals. Okay, so animal will be animals. Okay, so they are the animal predators. Okay, so you can see that some of the predators are also found in Arctic region. So some of them are polar bear, Arctic wolf, and Arctic fox. So these are the animals which are seen in the Arctic region, and these are the animals which depend on the animals and they eat the animals. Okay, so is it clear to you on this? Then here you can see the animals which are found in the polar regions, like killer whales. So these are the animals, whales which are wild animals. Okay, so they are the killer whales, and then Arctic fox. So here you see that this is the Arctic fox. Okay, then the polar zone, which where you can see that a bear is found, that is polar bear we call it then, and this animal will be mostly seen in the polar regions, and it has thick fur. So we call what I told you, that with the fur they can protect themselves from the freezing cold. So same way this animal will have a thick fur, you can see that, so that they can protect themselves from the harsh cold. Okay, then now here you can see that animals of Antarctic region. Now we studied about Arctic region. Now animals of Antarctic region, you can see that they live near the oceans. Okay, so normally Arctic region will have people there. Okay, and animals will be seen. Here in Antarctic region, you can see that most of the animals live in the ocean. Okay, so as it is frozen area and most of the ocean is there, southern ocean is seen there. So here you can see that, so normally they will depend on the fish. Okay, so they will eat fish or any other animals. Okay, as only few plants will be grown in Antarctic region. Okay, so this is the reason why animals depend on fish. Okay, and animals. Then you can see that most of the animals which are seen here that are penguins. Okay, they are the most well-known creatures in Antarctic region. Okay, so they have a thick skin, so they can easily live in the Antarctic region. So these penguins can be seen in Antarctic region, and they cannot fly. As we know that they have the wings, but they cannot fly. What they do? They swim and fish. They try to eat. You can see that, and they will swim and fish in the seas using their wings and what it is called as pedals. Okay, so they will be having pedals, leg pedals, and the wings, and with that they will move and they will swim in the water. Okay, the seas have different kinds of seals and whales. So here you can see that some of the seals and whales are also seen here. And even in the North Polar Seas, you can find some of the walruses, which are well known seen in the North Poles. Okay, so here you see that these are the pictures. Okay, so penguins is a picture of penguins. So these are the wings with that it tries to swim. Okay, so they will be having wings and they will try to swim. Okay, and the walruses. So this is a walrus. Okay, which I told you, which mostly are seen in the northern region, North Pole. Okay. Now, what type of life, okay, the people live in this region? Okay, so that we are going to study. That is Antarctica does not have the people of its own. So Antarctica region, which is at the South Pole, does not have people. Okay? So people were not originated from there. So most of the people, you can see that they are the scientists, where they have been, what we can say, from different countries, they went to that Antarctic region for many reasons, like study the land, climate, plant and animals of the region. So they went there for the study of this, all the things. So scientists were from the different countries. Okay, so they went there and they go there and they live in the research stations and they do study on the land, the plant, the animals and the climate of the regions. Okay, Antarctic regions. As you can see that population will be very less. So only the people who go for study. So those people will be scientists will be going there on the research station. Okay. So here you can see next the Arctic region, which is the North Pole. Okay. So they will be having thousands of population. Okay. And it has been originated. You can see that from there, and you can see that has been the home for the thousand years. So many of the people have been living there for thousands of years. Okay. So among the people, you can see that who live in the some of the places which are known for many places. So for example, you can see that who live are the Inuit. Okay, they are called as Inuit of North America. So the people who live there, so they are called as Inuit of the North America and Greenland. Okay, so the people who live there, they are called with the names Inuit. Okay, and then the Sami, which are also called as Laps. Okay. And of which country? Northern Europe. And you can see that Nenets are called in the Northern Asia. So they have given different names for the people who live in this. So these are the tribal groups. So where they have given the different names. So Inuit you can see find in North America and Greenland. The Sami, they are also called as Laps. They can be seen in North Europe and Nenets in Northern Asia. Okay. Then people who get food, okay, from where do they get food? They get food by hunting animals. Okay, like which animals? Seals, whales, musk, oxen, walruses, and polar bears. So these animals they hunt and they get food from these animals. Okay, then fishing is an important activity here. For what purpose? For their source of food. Okay, so the people who live here, they will do fishing. Okay, and you can see that even in summer season they can gather, they will carry with them, they can collect berries and food plants. So some berries will be grown there, so that also is the food for the people. So berries and you can see that food plants are grown there. Okay, so this is the nothing but the source of food for the people. Okay, then some people keep herds. Okay, so what they do, some animals, the domestic. Okay, so for what purpose? For the, what we can say, for eating purpose also. So those people who are non-vegetarian, so they depend on the animals. Okay, so you can see that they herd animals. Okay, domesticated animals like reindeer. For what purpose? Milk, meat and skin. So multi-purpose. So they can use, you can make use of these animals for many purposes. They can get milk also, they can get meat also, even the skin. Okay, so these, you can see that things you can find in the Arctic region. Then there are some farms where animals are raised. So some of the farms are seen in the Arctic region in the North Pole, where they will what we can say, look after the animals. Okay, so the occupation will be herding the animals, raising the animals. So some people, even you can see that they work in the mines and fields also. So these all occupations can be seen in the North Pole, that is Arctic region. As the area, you can see that it is not that much frozen. So most of the people, you can see that they are living in the Arctic region. Here you can see that the animals which are shown here, like caribou. Okay, so this is one of the animal which is seen in the polar zone. Then snowy owl. Okay, so these are the some of the animals which are seen in the polar regions. Then in Arctic, you can see that people, they wear warm clothes. Okay, so what type of clothes? Like hooded jackets. So they will be having hooded jackets. They will wear those hooded jackets to protect themselves from the cold. So they will have those hooded jackets. Okay, so that they can protect themselves from the harsh cold, freezing cold. Okay, and some of the clothes which are made from animal skin. Okay, so as you can see that they hunt animals for many reasons. Okay, so they can get the skin also, which can be made convert into for the clothes to protect themselves. Okay, so they remove the skin of the animals like seal and reindeer. And nowadays you can see that people even they use the clothes which are made from the synthetic materials and also used for making clothes. So even you can see that some of the people now they are using synthetic materials for making clothes. Okay, even you can see that people they make the clothes from the animal skin. Okay, sorry. Then early people shifted home in the search of hunting animals. So earlier people used to shift. They used to migrate. They used to move from one place to another place in search of food, and they used to hunt the animals, which was the source of food for them. Okay, so this was same in the early times, but now we can see that there are many changes. So here we see that people now they have been settling in the towns. They started living in the towns. Okay, and it is difficult now. Here we see what happened when they started settling down in the towns, which they developed the towns. Now it was very difficult to build the roads, okay, and the railways, as the ground is already covered with the snow. Okay, so it becomes difficult for them to construct roads or railways as the area is covered with the snow. Then people travel. Also, what they do, the alternate option for that, the people travel on sledges. You might have seen in the polar regions. Okay, so the dogs will be what we can say, they will be taking the passengers, and it is called nothing but sledge. Okay, so dogs will be running and taking the passengers and the what we call it as the luggage. Okay, so these are nothing but what huskies they call it as, and it is pulled by rich people, thick coated dogs. So these dogs will be seen in the polar regions, which they will be having thick skin, and they are, we can see that they will be pulled by huskies and or by the reindeer. Even you can see that reindeer also pulls the sledges. Okay, so these days many people use snowmobile on land, okay, and motor boats to what we can say to travel from one place to another place. Okay, so these are the sources of transport, we can call it as, where people can move from one place to another place. So children, now whatever I told you or explained you, you might have understood this. Along with this, again I will show you one video. Okay, so that you have to understand, and you can easily understand the video. Okay, so I will be showing you one video which will explain the entire lesson. That is the polar regions.
There are two fridges zones, one in each hemisphere.
better you might have understood the lesson. Yes. So whatever I have explained you today, I'm in the first video. Please go through this video, okay, and the first video also, so that you can understand nicely. And already I have sent you the oral question answers. Okay. So today with this video link, I will be sending you the other question answers and also the objective answers. Okay. So that answers you will be writing in the notebook, and the objectives will be marking in the textbook. Okay, children. So the lesson is complete here. So please try to complete it so that in the next session I can start the next lesson. Okay. Be safe at home. Thank you, children.